ragworm are quite an active worm, marine worm. They wriggle a lot. Lugworm are pretty dormant once they're on the hook. All they do is offer a lot of scent. But ragworm are wriggly. If we can get one to wriggle for you, you can see they're moving all the time. Now that brings an advantage, another advantage. Apart from scent, it brings the advantage of movement. They tend to be a clear water bait. They work quite a lot in clear water. And of course, fish are able to pick up vibration as well. So any movement of a bait brings an advantage. Quite a lot of the time, you can mix those different qualities of a bait together. And that is what we've done here when we started with a cocktail. With ragworm, those pinchers are pretty evil on the fingers if you're not careful. So a baiting needle is quite handy to bait them. Again, just push the worm onto the needle. The hook goes into the end. There's a small hole in the end of the baiting needle. Hold it tight, and the worm goes straight on the hook, like that. Now with ragworm, as I said, you want the wriggly tails. So it's a good idea when you're using ragworm, depending on the size, because they do come in a variety of sizes. These are pretty medium-sized worms. So we can put a head-hooked small ragworm on the back of the bait. Now we've got a nice, scenty, juicy bait and a bit of movement as well. And if you can get that in the sea, that combination will really appeal to the fish. These beads, by the way, these are floating beads, and the effect they have on a bait is to raise it slightly off the bottom. They've just recently, in the last few years, come into sea angling, and they are gaining in popularity. And you can really, it's another aspect of bait, that you can alter the behaviour of a bait on the bottom by adding a few beads to make it float up. It puts the bait at a different angle to the fish. Instead of it being laying on the bottom, he may be able to see it moving in the tide. Now the other type of ragworm is the white rag. These are very active and very wriggly, as you can see. They just get the fish going mad when they see that movement. They're homing on from a distance. And if you ever watch fish in a tank, it's a good way, if you're interested in bait, to throw a few worms in an aquarium, with a sea aquarium, and see what white rag does to fish. It makes them go crazy. So a lot of anglers use the white rag just as that final little cocktail on the end of a bait to add that little bit of movement. As you saw in the ragworm, that gives that extra dimension to the bait. And it may be the one thing that makes the fish take it. We'll just put a white rag on the end. Bit fiddly to do. Again, you can do it with a bait needle. But the secret of these ragworm is to leave a little tail that wriggles at the end.